Hey, 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 it's Michelle Yvette. Welcome to the Michelle Yvette Cummings Show. I always wanted to have my own talk show, so you know what? I just decided that I would have my own show. So sometimes I'm working out, sometimes I'm cooking, sometimes I'm doing weird things like riding around with the sun, moon, and stars. Sugar. I got four bags of powdered sugar. Since I'm out, might as well have some fun. And I got a cake in the oven. I got a cake in the oven with 11 minutes left on the timer. So, I made this, I met this man last week. I decided that I would take, I'm making sure my teeth are clean. I decided that I would take some of my cupcakes out with me last week while I was running errands. No, the week before last, because this is a new week now. So yeah, I think it was maybe last Tuesday before last. I was out and I was like, I'm going to take some of my goodies with me because I'm always passing out my business card. And a lot of times people ask me, especially men, do you got something on you now? So I did. And I met this man at the Brookshire's parking lot. And, you know, I walked up to his car and he was like, what you got? And I told him I had some lemon pound cake cupcakes. Lemon pound cake cupcakes. Say that three times real fast. Okay, so I had some lemon pound cake cupcakes and he was like, how much are they? I was like, $12 for half a dozen. And so he was like, I'm just gonna give you $12. I don't want the cupcakes. I don't like a lemon. My thing is sweet potato pie. I love sweet potato pie. So I said, I can make you a sweet potato pie, no problem. And this $12 will just go towards your bill. And then I told him that I made a sweet potato pie cheesecake this past summer. I was doing the low carb thing. And I made a sweet potato pie cheesecake, except instead of sweet potato, I used butternut squash. And instead of a graham cracker crust, I use pecans. But when I made that cheesecake, it was delicious as all get out. But it was not layered because the butternut squash mixture was too thin, you know. And so it wasn't strong enough to support the cheesecake mixture. And I saw this cheesecake on Stovetop Kisses channel on YouTube, and you know, I'm very attracted to things that are different and unique because I'm just quirky that way. I like unique creative things, right? And so when I saw this sweet potato pie cheesecake, I was like, like, that looks so good. Oh, I want to make that. So I've made that version for this guy. So when I let him know that I was about to make his stuff, he told me he was out of town until Monday or Tuesday. And I believe it was probably like Thursday or Friday when I messaged him. So I was like, that's okay. I'll just put your stuff in the freezer and when you get back, you can pick it up, right? And I was like, you owe me $68. That's your balance. So he was like, okay. So when I finished the sweet potato pie, I took a picture of it and I sent it to him. And then his response was, you have the wrong number. Now, we already text, okay? So, like, why are you pretending like I got the wrong number? So I took a picture of the business card that he gave me. I'm all sweaty because I just got through working out, y'all. But I took a picture of the business card that he gave me. And I said, is this not your business card, Samuel? And so then he responded, I can't remember what he responded. I have it in my other phone. It ain't worth looking for. But anyway, I told him that, you know, the stuff was in, I would have it in the freezer. And so when I contacted him, you know, he didn't contact me. Tuesday came, and I figured, you know, when you're coming in from out of town, you're tired or whatever. So Wednesday went by, hadn't heard from him. Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Today was Sunday. So I called him on the phone. Hey. So he starts talking to me about some invoice, right? He thinks I'm somebody else. And so I said, I'm sorry, you have me confused. I'm the lady you ordered the sweet potato pie and sweet potato pie cheesecake from, and I told you that I would have it in the freezer. So I was just checking with you because I hadn't heard from you and I have the stuff in my freezer. And, you know, I had taken it out. I took the stuff out the freezer yesterday because I made a sweet potato pie for my mom and she ate it in one day. So I was like, I'll just give her that sweet potato pie and, you know. I wanted to cut into this cheesecake because I want the photo for my Facebook feed and my Instagram feed. The photo of the striped sweet potato cheesecake layers. So, here it is. This is a cheesecake. And I've got it all covered up. And I'm gonna stop and wash my hands again because I just wiped all the sweat off my face because, you know, I'm a clean freak, okay? And there's a pimple. Anyway, my intention is to sell the slices because somebody's gonna see it and they're gonna be like, I wanna try that. So, you know, I'll sell them the slices. So, but I'm going to give me a slice. So, here we go. You know how you, I just put cold water on my face. I'm so hot. Baby, that was a good workout. I did over 20 minutes of ab work. So, I'm really focusing on really focusing on getting a flat tummy because honey I realized you can walk until the cows come home. Walking is not abdominal work. I lost 60 pounds last year doing a liquid fast. I did a liquid fast for 182 days and I lost 60 pounds, but I still have a tummy. And this summer when I rediscovered my grandmother's pound cake recipe, because I had forgotten it, I hadn't baked in over 20 years. And my cousin invited my mom to a Mother's Day shindig, and of course I had to take her. And then my other cousin got to talking about my grandmother's pound cake. She was like, girl, no, let me be accurate. Good, that pound cake Aunt Florence used to make. That's my grandmother's name, Florence. She was her aunt. And I named my mixer after my grandmother. My mixer's name is Florence. And she was like, you know, I got the recipe. And I was like, do you really? And she was like, yeah. I was like, will you take a picture of it and send it to me? And she was like, yeah. And she did, and it wasn't a good picture, so I couldn't see anything hardly. So I was like, can I come over and take a picture of it? She was like, yeah. So I went over and she gave me a picture. I took a picture of it, and then I went to the library and printed them out. And When I saw the recipe, it jogged my memory because my grandmother didn't exactly go by that recipe. She had a little, you know, a little alteration that she did to the recipe. So, you know, I remembered all that. So I started baking that pound cake and it took me right back to my grandmother's house and right back to teenagerdom when I didn't, you know, wasn't worried about my weight because I was already thin. So, yeah, I started baking and I just, you know, really fell in love with baking. And just next thing I knew, I gained 14 pounds. The 6 pounds I gained before I started baking, I passed by Whataburger one day. Whataburger is a fast food chain here that's, you know, in the South, I guess. It's in, I know it's in Shreveport. But I hadn't had Whataburger in a long time. I was still doing a vegetarian thing, even after I started eating solid food again. And so when I saw Whataburger, I was like, oh, there ain't no cars in the line. It's, now's my chance, right? So I went to Whataburger and I had avocado bacon burger that first day. I made sure I had a diet lemonade, but the next day I was like, that wasn't satisfying enough because it was only one meat patty. So the next day I went and got a patty melt. And then I was like, now I want the mushroom Swiss burger. And then I was like, and I miss that sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit breakfast too. So I'm going to go get that too. And then I was like, I really miss Panda Express, that honey walnut shrimp from Panda Express with the fried rice. I missed that. So I basically had a fast food binge that week and I literally gained 6 pounds in 1 week. Literally. I don't even know. How is that possible? But it happened to me. And then when I started baking, I gained another 14 pounds real quick. So it is what it is. I'm 177 now, but I'm on my way back down. And I'm gonna cut into the cheesecake. I'm gonna lower my tripod so y'all can see my plate here. And this is the cheesecake. I'm gonna take it off the board. Got one of these El Cheapo cake pans from the Dollar Tree. And I'm glad I bought it because that little cheap thing comes in handy. It's great for freezing my stuff. See, I had this little cheesecake all wrapped up all good. I'm gonna get this cheesecake, baby. Okay, so there it is. And you can see the layers on the side. Doesn't that look yummy? I just love, love, love. So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to cut it in half. I hope my half is, I hope that's a good half. I'm always thinking business, honey. Seriously, this is a whole meal. But I want to go ahead and cut it. Just do that one cut so I'm not just repeatedly cutting into it. And I'm gonna package these slices up and put them in the freezer. And one of these days I'm gonna go out and I'm gonna have these slices. I'm gonna sell these babies. When I talked to the man today, he was like giving me some story about how he was in Dallas trying to recoup money from some customers he was doing some handyman or construction work for, and telling me that he was in danger of being evicted, blah blah blah. And oh, that is so good. I just wiped that off of that knife and put it in my mouth. So anyway, yeah, he was telling me about how the people hadn't paid him, and he was sitting out in front of the house all day waiting for them to come, and nobody ever came. And he said, well, that pie and that cheesecake gonna be my Thanksgiving dinner. I'm gonna get you your $68. Look at that. See those layers? Yes, honey, yes. See that alternating sweet potato and cheesecake in there. Now I gotta stop and take a still photo. I was gonna stop and take a still photo, but I don't have to do that because I can just take a screenshot. Whoa! Okay. There it is. Can you see that? See those layers? I'm thinking about my Facebook stories. That's exactly how I'm gonna be. You know you want it. Don't you want it? You know you want it bad.